Welcome to Connie Martinson Talks Books. I have a treat for you. I've just read a phenomenally great book, Characters You Don't Believe That Could Be Walking on the Street. It's the true nature of people. The book is called When the Devil Holds the Candle. It's an Inspector Sayre series. You will look at it as an American and say Sager, but it is translated from the Norwegian. It is written by my guest, Karen Fossum. It's published by Harcourt. Mm. Welcome, Karen.
Thank you very much.
I do not know when I have been so drawn into a book as I have with this book. Mm. And the fact that two people, Andres and his friend Zip, are like they came out of Clockwork Orange.
Yes, that's true.
Do you remember the Clockwork?
I remember.
They are totally immoral or amoral, and their only instinct is what pleases me.
Yes.
I don't care if I hurt or if only I want to hurt other people. Mm.
They're looking for excitement in a way, these two boys.
Yeah.
Because life is dull, the city is dull, they need action. So they just drive around and try to get some action.
But the meanness of picking on a very sweet little boy named Mateus.
Yes, I know.
Who is from Somalia and has been adopted. The interesting thing in this book, everybody is connected.
Yes,
in some way, and that you say, oh, well, that of course that makes sense. Mm. Yeah.
Yes, yes. Now, first I would like to say something about the title to the viewers. It's a Norwegian saying, you cannot see much when the devil holds the candle.
Could you read that paragraph that says it?
I don't have my glasses on, but I will try. Yes, the God that I don't believe in knows that I have seen Andreas. I think back to that terrifying moment when I felt it coming, the desire to destroy him. At the same instant, I saw my own face reflected in the window pane, and I remember the feeling, a sweet pressure like warm oil running through my body, the certainty that this was evil. My face in the bluish glass, the hideous evil person you become when the devil holds the candle.
Yeah, and I said, aha, that's where the title comes from. But you begin the book as with the voice of Irma.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is a story about a very lonely and a very disturbed woman with a big, dark, and she thinks ugly secret.
Yeah,
and as long as she's left alone, she's well behaved, but then these two boys, they do disturb her.
And yet, in destroying her, she becomes the destroyer.
Yes, she does.
Yeah.
Yes.
Let's tell our friends a little bit about that first day of Andreas and Zip, where first they pick on Mateus, and then their modus operandi is to find a defenseless person and grab the person's handbag or whatever. And in one case where they do it, the woman is wheeling a baby in a carriage.
Yes. Well, all these two guys want is money so they can buy themselves a couple of beer. And I don't think it's such a big thing. It's not a big crime or anything. It's just fun. It's just a game. But I must point out that Zip is a bit more what's it called in English? He's not as bad as Andreas.
Yeah.
Andreas is the leader. Zip follows him.
Mm-hmm.
I think.
But Andreas supports Zip.
Yes.
There's that symbiotic relationship that they have, so that when they rip the pocketbook from the lady, they're on the edge of a cliff.
Yes, they
are. And the child falls
Yes.
out of the carriage. And later, all of these things pile up.
Yeah, I know.
But Irma is remembering them in the beginning when she tries to get the police to come to her home. Mm. And she says, he's dying, he's going to die. Yeah. And then she walks away.
Yes, she does.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think it's my most dramatic story of all the books I have written. This is, in a way, it's the hardest one, the toughest one to read. It's because there's so much pain in it, in a way.
Yeah.
Yes.
And as I said, there is that Clockwork Orange feeling about these two boys.
Yes.
And yet you do an interesting thing as an author. Andreas suddenly reveals how he feels about Zip.
Yes.
And it's as if it's a cataclysmic cut in their friendship.
Yes. It's dramatic, but at the same time, there's something beautiful about it, because Zip accepts it. He really does. At first, he's shocked, angry,
how
furious.
How dare you make a pass
offended.
At me?
Offended. Yeah. I mean, but then he does some thinking, doesn't he? And he thinks, okay, but he's still my friend. He's my best friend. I can't leave him, and he doesn't. There's something good about him.
Tell us about Inspector Sayre, as you call him.
Yes. I like him a lot. When I started to do these books, I was looking for, you know, I had to create some kind of hero. And then I looked around and I felt everything was done. There was nothing left for me to do. What kind of hero should I create? And then I thought back to my childhood when I was a girl in the 50s and 60s. And then, in a way, I picked the kind of man that would be the hero when I was a child. And that would be guys like Jim Reeves, Dr. Kildare. Those kinds of men, well-dressed, polite, decent men. And so I thought, that's my guy.
Yeah.
And in a way, I didn't expect that people would come to love him that much, because he never does anything wrong. He doesn't drink too much. He doesn't swear. He's clever, a bit shy, handsome. He works out.
He has a lady friend, Sarah.
Yes, because I didn't want him to stand out. I didn't want him to be that important in the books, because I want the case to be important.
You're right. I mean, I read it and I thought, this is a book that could stand alone. It stands alone with what happens between Irma, the shock that causes Andreas to fall down the cellar. All of that is part of even his mother, Andreas's mother, Rooney, who turns out to be Irma's good friend.
Yes, that's true.
I mean, the way you tie this whole thing in, and reading it, you're not aware that it's going to be Andreas's mother who's been calling Irma to come out to theater to do this with her.
Yes. No, that's true. Yeah. But I never plan things ahead. I just, in a way, I make a scene and then I throw some people out on the scene.
Yeah.
And then I hope that they will act.
Yeah.
And that there will be some kind of drama between them.
How much rewriting do you do? Because so much of this is interior, is descriptive.